afternoon baseball here on the show. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Interleague Baseball on the show. Mike Minor, a southpaw from Tennessee, is the man on the mound. And please, Zach, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Settling in now, Dylan Carlson. He will lead this one off today. First pitch of the at-bat. And that misses for ball one. Now the 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Forecast high calls for 80 degrees, but we're at 76 here at opening pitch. The 1-1 home. Swung on and missed, and the leadoff man has gone on strikes to start the afternoon.
One of the big advantages to pitching and hitting the count of your pitcher, because you have to cover both pitches if you're a hitter. You have to cover the off-speed and the fastball. And in a 1-2 count, you might be sitting off-speed, and what happens? He gets the fastball, and you can't catch up to the express.
Stepping in now, Luis Renfro. And a first pitch swing, he hits a fly ball to left center. Williams comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number two. Next to bat for Toronto, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And now pitch on the way. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. So let's take a look at our umpiring crew in this one. Working the plate, Rusty Valentine.
Dan, Rusty Valentine behind the dish tonight. He is north-south without question, letters to knees.
I tell you what, he really favors a power pitcher. If you can consistently pitch at about the chest level and above, he'll call that high strike zone. I think he's a very friendly pitcher's umpire.
This is in the air out to right field. And he will make the catch just shy of the track, and the inning is over. Blue Jays go down in order, so now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Trent Thornton gets the ball for the Blue Jays in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on it?
Hey, it just goes to show you how tough it is to pitch in today's game. This guy has a career ERA over 5. At times he can be good, and at times he can be really, really bad. It'll be interesting to see which guy shows up in this one here today.
Standing in, Cesar Hernandez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The pitch. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. This is foul for the first strike. Low roller, and he bare hands it. A ball and a strike to the Phillies leadoff man. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. Softly down the line toward first. And there's one away. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Jean Segura. Here comes the first pitch. misses inside with the fastball there. And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Bases are empty. One man out. Philly shortstop in front of the count, 3-1. Mark Withenshaw will be next. Third baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And he missed with that one. It's ball four. One out walk here in the home first. Stepping in, Mark Withenshaw. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Kicks and deals. And that's in there for strike one.
Hey, it's nearly impossible to turn two with a guy that can run like this. It's even harder when he comes out of the box hitting from the left side. You really need something tailor-made to even have a chance to get him at first.
High in the air out to center field. Number 25 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. It'll be the four-hole hitter, Bryce Harper, a Silver Slugger recipient for National League Outfielders a year ago. Here it comes.
Nope, up there.
Segura is off of first with two away. Roll over to the bag, and he just manages to get his hand in. Ball and a strike.
1-1.
It's 1-2.
One ball, two.
Not likely to see a fourth fastball in this situation. I'm going to eliminate the fastball if I'm at the plate right here.
Two. Yeah, swung on and missed. He got him. Philly strand one, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Nordis Gurriel. Here's the first offering. And this is pop foul, but perhaps playable behind first. And that'll slice just foul at the last moment. The 0-1 delivery. Hit out towards second. First will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Number 25.
Still stepping in for the Jays, number 25. He's ready for his first AB here in this one. Now the pitch. And a fastball misses here to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Into the corner and slicing foul. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Fastball called strike. 1-2.
1-2.
Heading out towards shallow right. Harper coming on. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now.
Number 3.
Into the box now, Martinez, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Here it comes. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And Hoskins is there to make the catch. The inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Next to bat will be Reese Hoskins, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. Outfield shaded a bit to left center, the first pitch. Thornton has become known as a guy that's tough to take deep. So many starting pitchers find themselves snake bitten by the gopher ball, but he really limits that. Wind up and the 1-0 pitch. And that's right there, and we're even at one. And he fouls this one off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. The 2-2 one more time. Bounced on the ground and right after shifted infield. And a good throw gets in one gun. To the plate for the Phils, Nick Williams. First delivery to him on the way.
At the ball.
The 1-0.
So that's two pitches in a row above the belt. As a hitter, that's what you're looking for, especially when it's a day game and the ball is carrying. That just wasn't a good enough pitch to hit.
3-1 count to the Phillies left fielder. Called a strike and it's full 3-2. Left side, but well fouled. Payoff pitch one more time. And he misses here for ball 4. Already 2 walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up 2 walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to beat.
Stepping into the box, Omar Narvaez. Jensen whips on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. From the belt, kicks and deals. One, here's the pitch. Softly hit toward the hole. And the off-balance throw is right there for the third out. And a high degree of difficulty on that one as the side is retired. One left for Philadelphia. We'll move to the third with no score. Now at the plate, number 71. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
It's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
The pitch. Set to deliver the 0-1. Fouled off. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
Next is Danny Jansen. And she'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Ball and a strike. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Trent Thornton. First pitch on its way. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Blue Jays pitcher with an even 1-1 count. Now a ball lined to the left side, but this will be a foul ball. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
I don't know if that was discipline or whether he's just not swinging the bat at all, but hey, at least he's making the pitcher throw a few more pitches.
Now here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting into shallow right field. Hernandez has got it, and the side is retired. Blue Jays go down in order. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Next up would be the Phillies pitch.
pitcher, Mike Minor, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Good fastball as he gets the swing and miss.
Hey, if you're able to blow a first pitch fastball by a guy, gotta believe that pitch is coming again right here.
Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
I'm interested to watch this next pitch right here. He got a swing on a high fastball. I wonder if he's going to pull the old PSAC and climb the ladder.
Down the first baseline. And the Phillies are into the hit column.
Hey, this is perfect storm right here. This is how big innings start.
Thank you. set swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing in one. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Fouled away. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. And it's fouled away.
Hey, that fastball caught too much of the plate on an 0-2 count.
The 1-2. And he fouls this one off. No runs, no hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. Now swing and a little tapper to the left of the mound. Throw too late to get him at first. Not a thing of beauty, but it's an infield single nonetheless.
Hey, listen, D-Roll, they're going to be able to play that a little base hit is a base hit, even though that's an infield single. And hopefully, that's a good sign that things are about to turn for them in this game.
Yeah, there hasn't been a fight in the back right in this one.
I don't care what not. I don't care if it's a swinging bunt or a home run into the street. This could get the offense.
Standing in now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Flied out in his first at-bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. Big swing and a miss at the fastball. He's behind in the count 0-2.
Ooh-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire, right on by.
Nothing in two count and the pitch.
Fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. To two balls and two strikes now.
Well, that curveball just doesn't look to have the same snap on it that it normally does. Both of those last two have been pretty flat, and that's a pitch he relies on coming in.
Swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great striking pitch.
At the plate now, Jordan Gurriel in there, now the throw. He's not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely.
Good steal of second there, and that really sets up the middle of this order to drive in a run and break this scoreless ball game. Always great if you can score first early in the game.
From set, the 0-1.
One ball, one strike.
No runs, just one hit. No errors in the game for Toronto. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. This is popped up. Hoskins is there for it. And the inning is over. Blue Jays held in check. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Thomas Pannone, a lefty standing 6 foot even, takes over the pitching duties here.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Bryce Harper, feeling to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You can tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
This guy loves to drop the head on those pitches down and in. I'm shocked he went in there, but he's able to jump ahead and get away with it.
One, the count to Bryce Harper.
Hey, curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
That's the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Bouncer up the middle. Reined in. And he's safe.
Hey, there's a ball in the infield base hit right there. That kind of reminded me of the old Yankee shortstop, Derek Jeter, on that jump throw.
Hey, that's why this is the pros. Back in the day, that's a knock all day long. But up here, guys are making those plays, at least making you think about them. That's an amazing play by the shortstop to leave his feet and at least make this play. Reese Hoskins
is at the plate as he looks at ball one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. For the first strike. Strike two, swinging.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel on that one.
Omar Narvaez, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one.
Narvaez is unlike many of today's hitters in the sense that he doesn't have a lot of swing and miss in his approach at the plate. More often than not, he gets contact, and I'm sure that makes him a frustrating hitter to face from a pitcher's standpoint.
You know, he takes his chances when he has count leverage. Without question, 1-0, 2-0, you'll see this guy try and get nasty a little bit. But he stays within himself, he knows what his strengths are, and he tries to drive the ball right back where it came from.
Down now at 2-1.
Gutsy pitch right there. 2-0 changeup for a strike. Good call by the catcher. Great execution by the pitcher.
Fouled away. Two out here and a runner at second.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of hitting in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Skied into straightaway right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. One left for Philadelphia. Through four, still tied, nothing. Zach Eflin, right-hander standing 6'6", will take over pitching duties here. Ready for another chance, number 25 comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First pitch on its way. 4-1. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. This is two and one. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup.
Guess who tipped their hand? They were sitting all over a piece of cheese. He flew open on the front side.
Struck him out.
These days, 94 miles an hour is good, but not as impressive as it used to be. Professional hitters can catch up with that, so it's all about setting the fastball up with good off-speed stuff to make it look more effective, and that's exactly what he did right there.
Into the box now, Martinez. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Slider, but it's 1-1. One out, nobody on. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Withenshaw is in his tracks now, and there's the second out of the inning. Plate number 71. He is 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch coming, here it is. And this is just off the outside corner for a ball, 1-0. And well off the plate with the change of pace, that's ball two. Two out, nobody on. Too high, and it's 3-0. Danny Jansen would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And There's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Lifted down the line and left. Williams is under it. And he pulls it down in the corner. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. Halfway home, still no score. Number 33 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 33.
Bottom of the inning now, and into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. First pitch on its way.
1-0.
And now the Blue Jays get a left-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front, the ball and a strike. Lifted the other way out to left center. Gurriel is right there, and he's got it for out number one. Number 26 will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Off the plate, ball one.
That's not a bad pitch right there. That two-seamer moving away from a left-handed hitter. Didn't get the strike, but I like the idea behind the pitch.
Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder giving chase. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Cesar Hernandez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First delivery to him on the way. Took a little off and it's in for a called strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit hard towards center. That gets down and he's got himself a base hit. So the two out hit here brings up Gene Segura.
Piece of hitting right there. Didn't try and do too much. Dear middle five places of right back there.
Gene Segura standing in. That's the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through. Here comes the 0-1. One ball, one strike. Broke out the slide step there, Dan.
Yeah, he's really thinking about the steal right here.
Deal,
it happened, but the cat and mouse game continues.
Pitch outside.
He's out.
And he is out at second. Caught stealing to end the inning. Another look at the throwdown that results in a third out on the bases. We're back with more from the Grapefruit League after this. Vince Velasquez. He makes his second appearance so far this spring. Oh. Danny Jansen. So far, 0-1 with a flyout.
First pitch of the at-bat. The 1-0. Offered at and missed for the first strike. To center field. Withenshaw is there, and he has it for the first out. Rowdy Tellez move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. This is in the dirt for ball one. The 1-0. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Bases are empty. One man. Liner towards second. Right to the second baseman, and that's the second out. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Blue Jays lineup. Stepping in, Dylan Carlson. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
Well, this isn't his more accomplished side. As a general rule, he's a much better hitter from the right side, but they're looking for him to come through here, swinging the bat left-handed.
1-0 count, here it is. Two out, nobody on. Big curveball right down the middle for strike number two.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate. That's a tough pitch to pull the trigger.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Blue Jays go down in order. We are still scoreless. Anthony K. managed to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. And that'll bring up Gene Segura. It ends off here in the Philadelphia sixth. Here's the pitch.
Two.
ground toward the left. And the base hit as that's in the left, and they've got themselves a base runner. Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper, and he fouls this one off. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Now the 0-1. Oh, it looked like a caveman swing and a glove on that one. It's 0-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Up and in.
The 0-2, a look diverts. And he'll be back in standing up. Runner at first here, one man out. A bullet to first base. And they will apply the tag between first and second. It's a double play, and just like that, the side is retired. We're through six full, and we still have no score. Mike Morin is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Addison Russell puts up off the bench as he'll pinch in here to start inning number 7. Segura scooped up. And the throw count is inside, so the leadoff man is down here to start inning number 7. Willie Calhoun will come on as a pinch hitter. And a strike to start the at bat. Nothing one. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. Calhoun, playing here in his age 26 season. He was a fourth-round selection back in the 2015 MLB draft.
Hey, this middle round selection is still developing, and he's doing it at the big league level. And he has a lot of time to get his tool set on him.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Willie Calhoun will second out in the 7th inning. We'll get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with 2 out and the bases empty. A ball with no strikes. Second. And that is through into right field for a single.
The pitcher got the result he was looking for. Change up down in the zone gets him to hit it on the ground, but obviously the result wasn't what he wanted.
Come on, a pinch hit here in a big spot. Ball here as we'll take a look at ball 1-0. From the belt, kicks and deals. Got his 2-0 fastball, but he was way behind, 2-1. Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
High in the air out to center field. Withenshaw is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. One left for Toronto. Still no score. Harrison Russell will stay in the ballgame now as he comes on to play second here. Landon Gary remains in the game, batting eighth and manning left field. Number 76 takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch. Number 14 will also enter as he takes over at third base. Jonathan Davis will also come in now as he takes over out in center. Scott Kingery is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. Starting with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. Swing and a miss, 1-1. Kingery, playing here in his age 26 season. He was taken in the second round back in the 2015 MLB draft.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. This the other way to right. And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. And he is in the second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
And I don't think he could have dissected those fielders any better if he tried. Throw that one into the alley for the gap, and that'll bring him easily into second base.
Guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, man, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Set and the pitch. Side as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner.
Yeah, after the those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on the fastball right here.
Hit softly down the line at first. Well, this will line up a foul ball. 2-2. Open to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
That was a big strike out there, guys. This pitcher has the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point in the game. Could be something you look back on later when the game's over.
No indication from the dugout that they'll issue the free pass, and with the pitcher on deck, that'll force their hand here with two gone. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Comes set, the 0-1 on the ground to the right side. Dive and he knocks it down. Oh, he's going too late and the bases are loaded now. Is loaded and two out in the inning. Almost low and inside with it. One and one.
Boy, Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
Two balls and a strike.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Two out, bases loaded. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Phillies leave them loaded, and this is still a nothing-nothing ballgame. Andrew McCutchen is into the ballgame now, and she'll take over out in left field. Number 11 stays in the ballgame in the nine hole and takes over at second base. If he could have run over and summoned from the bullpen, as he'll do so to start the eighth. Number 6 is into the game as well, as he's the new first baseman. Anthony Alford is going to be asked to get things going here as a leadoff at the top of the eighth. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Strike one. Arono stands 6-2 and throws from the right side. He's a five-year vet at the major league level. Open up anymore. 71. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. And the pitch. Ripped down the line. This gets fouled, 0-1. Bases are empty, 1 man out. And he'll try attempting with one of the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Drill down the line. Now this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
Now with a runner at first and nobody out. score anyone.
Going at runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Pitch out.
Two balls, one strike.
Balls in a strike. He's coming behind now, 3-1.
This situation right here reminds me of sitting on the bench talking to John Smoltz, Hall of Famer. He would always say, even though the situation looked bad, the pitcher is one pitch away from getting himself out of the tough game.
Well hit. Deep down the right field line. And it's a foul ball. And he misses with it, ball four, so the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position.
Wow, that was a slide. It just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. Good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Here's Bryce Harper now. He was a double play victim last time around.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can.
The 1-0. Laid off, but in there for strike one. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
You can't go after that pitch with less than two strikes on it. There's no way you're going to do any damage with a ball executed down in the lanes.
And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. What a way.
It's been a really rough day for this guy. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Stepping in now, number six, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls in the strike. He's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. With the 0-1. Swing and a liner. Foul. Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2.
Not surprised he's laid on the heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Next 0-2. High in the air out to center field.
Davis
is there. Two gone. Into the box. Andrew McCutchen. And a big at bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the end.
Unable to find the zone with the slider.
One and one to Andrew McCutchen.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as it keeps it above the letters.
Nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
one pitch.
Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
Hey, it's looking like he might be able to get out of this one after giving up two singles.
And here's the ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. But this will land untouched. This is going to wind up a foul ball. He's set to 2-2.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over.
So they let him off the hook here by scoring no runs despite the two walks. Ninth inning coming up, and we still have no score. We'll stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center. Hector Neris will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ballgame tied until the bottom half. So striding forward now,
Reese McGuire.
Coming, here it is.
They teach pitchers to keep the ball down, but if you can locate upstairs like that, it really gives you the ability to mess with the eye level of the batter.
0-1 count, here's the pitch. Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. One and two count to the Blue Jays signal caller. Against Hector Neris, he's gone 3-for-8. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. One out, nobody on. Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2.
Two mid-90s fastballs right there that he doesn't seem to think he can catch up to. I wouldn't be shocked if he came right at him again with another good one.
0-2 delivery. Strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's coming out to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Here's Addison Russell. A ball and no strikes. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. It up 1-1. Two out, nobody on. And we'll come back with 1-3 as the count moves to 2-1 now. This one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. Number 14 would be next. Three and one pitch. Popped him up.
Nivarnes
over to his right. And that ends the inning. Blue Jays go down in order. Still no score. Rendell Pritchard will stay in the game, taking over in right field and batting in the eighth spot. Here's to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra inning. At the plate, Omar Narvaez. He went down on strikes last time up.
He's got to put that one behind him. That especially requires in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. Solo shot here to left. And none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Well, when your one hit of the game is a home run and it ends up being a really critical one, you have to feel pretty good. It wasn't a huge day on the stat sheet, but it led his team to a win, and that's all you can hope for as a player.
Single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 final score. The Phillies came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Hector Neris pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watkin, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasquez, and you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Saturday. Look at him.